afternoon, or evening. Regardless of what time of day or night you're watching this video, it's me, Mikey Pipes. Thank you so much for tuning in. It is a little, oh shit, I still got the rollie on. It is 11:15, Sunday morning, January 8th, 2023. And I just landed me and Mrs. Pipe from PBI into JFK. Literally just landed, as you can see. I don't lie, keeping it real, right? And while I'm on the plane, I got a couple of voicemails for customers needing emergency service. I responded to two of them by text message. And one of them we're going to right now. We have a customer in New Hyde Park, an existing client. We did some plumbing work for them a couple years ago, and now they got no heat. And speaking to the lady on the phone, she said she has a Daikin furnace, which would be kind of rare because you really don't see many furnaces. And if you see a furnace, you're usually not going to see a Daikin. Just keeping it real. Just keeping it real. They don't really have that much of a brand dominance around here. But nonetheless, we're heading over to New Hyde Park. We're going to see what's going over there, and hopefully, we can get them up and running. Now, one of the things I do disclose on the phone with my clients before we're dispatched out to them is that I make them aware on a recorded line what the trip charge is and what the hourly rate is, and make them aware that it's both. We don't waive a trip charge. The trip charge is our time to come to your home, and the hourly rate is the hour that we can spend there. And there's no guarantee that we can fix the problem. Absolutely no guarantee. Right? And I also made it aware, listen, ma'am, you have a Daikin. If that's what you really have, I can't guarantee that we can fix it. Right? We stock a lot of parts in the truck for HVAC, you know, furnaces and boilers, but we don't stock everything, and nor can we ever. It's impossible to literally stock everything you need. Because number one, the inducer motors right there, you know, there's literally thousands of them, and maybe I'm exaggerating, hundreds of them out there, and you can't stock these inducer assemblies that cost hundreds of dollars a pop. So I'm just keeping it real. So as long as you keep it real with the clients on the phone, you know, there's no pushback. You know, God forbid you can't get them up and running and saying, oh, you didn't tell me. All right. Transparency. I believe in transparency. Make them aware of what they're obligated to and what they're signing up to when they call upon us. Unlike a regular service call during the week, you know, we can open up, you know, we can go to a supply house and get them parts generally. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please smash that thumbs up button, especially since we're at 99,000 subscribers. 99,000 subscribers. I think over the next couple days, we will hit that crazy epic milestone of 100,000 subscribers to the Mikey Pipes Pipe Doctor YouTube channel. And once that happens, I'm gonna make some really big, big moves. Unheard of for people in the trades with YouTube channels, at least to my knowledge. So stick around, it's really gonna be epic. And don't forget about the 50,000 subscriber pool party. That hasn't been put to the back burner. We're still gonna make that happen, all right, guys? So just bear with me, and we're gonna make some great moves together, I promise you. I really, really promise you. All right, let's get going.
All right, one of the first things I'm going to do is make sure my personal carbon monoxide monitor is on. Make sure it's in my pocket and make sure it's not silent. All right, let's go say hi.
Hello.
Hi, here for the heat?
Yeah.
Or lack of?
We don't have heat right now.
Okay, shall I come in?
Sure, sure.
Thank you.
Downstairs.
Okay, the thermostat is on or off right now?
Is it on?
Okay. Downstairs?
Yeah.
Left, right, straight?
Go straight. Open the door? Yeah.
Please don't touch the switch. Okay. A lot of light switches here. We did it. All right. You got a Daikin.
Yeah, it's a Daikin. We have that old though. Couple of years.
Filter. You replaced the filter in August, I see. Alright. Let's see where the switch is for this bad boy. Is there a light switch here? Nope. Let's.
This should be a switch.
Yeah?
Yeah. Can you write inside, maybe?
No. No, no switch here.
What about here?
Nope. All right, let me just slide some of these things out of the way. Let's see what we have inside going on. When did it stop working?
We found it in the morning.
This morning?
Yeah, early morning.
I don't see anything going on in there. Is there a switch for the equipment anywhere? I know you have a switch out here, but is there another switch? Where's the circuit breaker panel?
Circuit breaker here. Circuit breakers here.
And this is on. See if that did anything. I don't see nothing going on in there. I'm coming. Circuit breaker panels over here?
Yeah, actually this is red here. Maybe that's the one?
No, it's not circuit breaker panel.
It's that? No.
The main panel with the fuses.
Yeah, we have it.
All right, let me grab my tools from the truck.
Beautiful day here in New High Park. It is 11:39. I'm going to my truck. Get my tool bag. Who's got money on that? We got a power problem. You know, most of the time it is an electrical failure or electrical problem, but I got my money on something is off. And it's not gonna be the fuse. Who's with me? The first one to properly guess in the comments section. He's gonna win something. Maybe I'll send you a hat or a shirt or maybe even a pen, something.
Let's see what's in here. Jacuzzi's tripped, but I don't think it has anything to do with the furnace. Let's turn that off just in case. Jacuzzi. Everything else is on. Bath. Attic fan, dryer, microwave, refrigerator, AC outside. Everything else is on, but the jacuzzi circuit was tripped. So I turned that off for you.
Moving and I heard no sound.
No sound?
No sound from outside.
I smell something burnt. Which company am I?
Uh-huh.
Pipe Doctor. You called us, right?
Yeah.
Something smells not right. And why isn't this? Oh, there it is. Power switch. Let's check this fuse. Fuse looks okay. Nothing. I don't hear any power here. Absolutely nothing. So we got power there. But that smell is probably coming from that burnt up transformer. Testing for continuity. That fuse is good. All right, next we're gonna test for power coming out of the transformer. And we got no power coming out of the transformer. So let's test for power going into the transformer. I removed the wire for transformer H, which is transformer hot, and I just jumped onto one of the terminals for neutral. And I have voltage. I have voltage there, so I have a dead transformer.
Just to make sure, we're gonna power cycle this thing a couple times. I wiggled around the wires a little bit there, and there's nothing. So we've got a dead transformer.
All right, I didn't have any more transformers, so I took a R8285 fan center. It's got a 50 VA transformer there, and I used two Wagos to jump the the line voltage connections for 110 volts. And I took the R and the C of the transformer. Now we'll turn on and see what happens. We have action.
reducer assembly. So one of the last things I'm gonna check is the resistance across the hot surface igniter. I'm gonna check that hot surface igniter. All right, my resistance was 48, so I think we're good. Let's push the little button in, let this thing cycle up and wait for the gas valve to energize. I'm thinking she just died through normal wear and tear because I really am confident that the onboard fuse would have blown, but I guess we'll see what happens next. Reducer assembly. There's 110 volts in the hot surface igniter. Once that's on for a minute, we're going to have some voltage, 24 volts being fed to the gas valve, which is going to open up the gas valve and feed the gas train. Yes, the ignition flame sensor is going to sense that, which is right there. Shortly thereafter, the high limit sensor, which is right there, is going to sense the heat in the heat exchanger plenum, and that's going to turn the fan on. So if that's the case, we should be good to go. Have a effective transformer by means of normal wear and tear, and there's a equipment model cylinder, baby. There it is right there. There's our blower. And Houston, we are good to go. There's just one last thing to do. There you go. Stop. This unit may be under warranty. It's a great sticker. By the way, I get my stickers like this from Footbridge Media for $250 a month. They will do your website and your SEO, and they have a great, great, great price on stickers. I think like $2,000 is like literally $200. It's really, really cheap, and they do a whole bunch of other crazy printing services. Check them out, footbridgemedia.com. Link in the description box down below.
Ma'am? Yes? So I have a diagnosis and an estimate for you. The transformer or the component that interprets power and gives the furnace low voltage power was burnt out.
Low voltage.
Oh. So for testing purposes, we installed a new transformer. I don't know if you feel the air coming out of the vents. It's warm.
Oh, you put the transformer. Okay, let me see if air is coming.
All right, yeah, check the vents because it is blowing out hot right now. While you're checking, do you have a maintenance plan with us?
No.
No? Okay, so you have the trip charge and the labor charge and then the part. So let me give you the...
All right, I wish I recorded the last conversation with the homeowner after I discussed pricing. If you noticed, real quick, you know, I planted the seed about a maintenance agreement with them. I said, do you have a maintenance agreement? Okay, oh, you don't, I'm sorry. Okay, so then you have to pay the trip charge and the emergency service call charge plus the cost of the part. So, of course, you know, they're gonna, oh, check, maybe I pay. Maybe I have that. And I was like, ma'am, you would know it if you pay a monthly charge on your credit card. She goes, no. But plant the seed. And what I wanted to say is that if you notice when we walked into the garage, you saw the lights flicker? Well, apparently they've been flicking for about a week and a half. So I advised them, you know, because the daughter came out, from somewhere in the house. By the way, was, you know what I mean? And she had a question. I go, sir, you know, it's like, last night I, you know, the lights were flickering pretty bad. And like, you think this has something to do with it? I'm like, yeah, absolutely. You need to call the electric company as soon as possible. Call PSE&G Long Island. Tell them that the lights are flickering. And I saw it myself in the garage, and I thought it was kind of weird. But now that you mention it, you got to call the electric company as soon as possible. So, again, give them as much information as possible because you're going to further strengthen and develop the relationships that you have with your clients. And guess what? They're going to remember that. You know, it's free advice. Free advice, and you never know. That could have saved them a major fire hazard or more further damage. So, just keep that in mind. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm going to head on home. The dogs just got dropped off from the doggy boarder, a.k.a. the trainer. And the wife was home when they got brought back home. And I'm sure they're looking forward to seeing Abba, Daddy. So maybe I'll throw in the last segment of that.
in this clip. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I was very glad to be back. Florida was nice. We had nice, beautiful weather. You know, high 70s, low 80s, all sun, no rain since Thursday morning. So happy, and with the great sense of accomplishment that how far our channel has grown. 99,000 subscribers strong. It's amazing. It really is amazing. All right, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until next time, be well. God bless. Stay safe. Thank you again, guys. Love you. No homo.
All right, heading home. Not bad. 12:40. Let's say hi to the doggies. I wonder if they're hanging outside in the guest bedroom window. Let's see. All right, they're not in the window. So, let's see. Let's wait for the doggies. Let's see. Stoli! And Gigi. Hi.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I know. Oh my God, they're attacking me. Okay. Oh, they're attacking me. Oh no. Okay, calm down. Okay. Stop biting me. Okay, now you're biting me. That's not cool. Calm down. Yeah.